नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
हरि ओम। यज्ञमयः इज द नेक्स्ट नेम ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा। यज्ञ मीन्स सैक्रिफाइस, माया मीन्स हूज नेचर इज दैट। सो ट्रेडिशनली द वर्ड यज्ञ मीन्स अ रिचुअल, अ फायर रिचुअल, एंड दिस फायर रिचुअल इज द सीड ऑफ द होल क्रिएशन। इट इज सेड इन द मनुस्मृति, अग्नौ प्रास्ताहुति सम्यक् आदित्यम् उपतिष्ठते, आदित्याज्जायते वृष्टिः, वृष्टेरन्नं ततः प्रजाः। सो वेन द हवन इज डन, द ऑब्लेशन दैट वी ऑफर इन द फायर रीचेस द देवतास थ्रू द अग्नि, एंड वन ऑफ द देवतास इट रीचेस इज सूर्य, एंड थ्रू दैट देर आर रेन्स ऑन द अर्थ, एंड थ्रू द रेन्स द होल क्रिएशन इज सस्टेन्ड। And hence, the Yajna formed a central core part of the Vedas. Lord Shiva is of the nature of this Yajna, because Shiva means auspicious. And this Yajna is what brings auspiciousness in the whole creation. The whole creation is sustained by this Yajna. Now, this is the literal meaning of the Shloka. The glory of the Yajna is explained in the Manusmriti Shloka. Literally also, it is true. There are many research experiments which have been done where one has found the impact of yajna, the chanting of the mantras, how the environment around changes, the vibrations change, the ashes is used as manure, the water is mixed with these ashes and it is sprinkled on the leaves, etc. So there is a whole science of yajna farming. The science of sound also is there. The science of healing also is there. So yajna is very auspicious, there is no doubt in that. Literally also, the havan, when it is done, it has a lot of impact. Symbolically also, yajna bhavana is what is important. When everyone comes together for a common cause, sinking their own differences, working together, contributing their best, that spirit of working together selflessly for a common cause is called yajna bhavana. And when we say that Lord Shiva is of the nature of yajna, this working together selflessly for the good of the entire community is most auspicious. It is Shiva, where we let go of differences, where we destroy our pride, we come together and work shoulder to shoulder, whether it is for the country, for the community, for one's own family, for the village, for the town. It may be for rains, for somebody's longevity, for health, for well-being, for prosperity, any reason it could be. It is a very important aspect that we learn to work together and synergize, work as a team. This dynamic togetherness is what leads us to more and more success, prosperity. When we say yajna brings rain, yajna bhavati parjanyaha, says the Gita, this yajna is that effort. Puja Gurudev Swami Chinmayananda used to say that yajna is the cooperative endeavor for a selfless cause. The devatas are the productive potential that is there in everyone. Yajna invokes that productive potential. And the rains are the success and the prosperity when this potential is invoked and when everyone works together. Individually and as a community, one becomes successful. This bhavana of a yajna is most auspicious. Hence, Lord Shiva is called Yajnamayaha. It is also said in the Taittiriya Samhita that yajna vai Vishnuho, that yajna is of the nature of Vishnu. And all of us know that Shiva and Vishnu are one. They are not different. Apart from yajna being the means to come together and work selflessly, by itself, yajna is of the nature of the Supreme Lord. One of the names of Lord Vishnu is Yajnaha in the Vishnu Sahasranam. And in this Shiva Stotra Shatanamavali, also the name of Lord Shiva is Yajnamayaha. So Shiva and Vishnu, both are of the nature of yajna, meaning yajna itself is divine. whether we know the meaning or not, when we do havan, when we do a yajna, it does not pollute the environment. Today, there is enough research to show that the specific samagri that is used in the yajna, the wood that is used in the yajna, purifies the environment. And hence, yajna itself is divine. And it also means, in the Gita, the Lord says, yajnyarthat karmano anyatra lokoyam karma bandhanaha tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sangha samachara. All those actions which are done without the spirit of yajna, meaning with selfishness for boosting one's own ego, with ego and egocentric desires, when these actions are done, they bind us more and more. But tadartham karma kaunteya, when the actions are dedicated to the Supreme, tad here means the Supreme Lord, Shiva or Vishnu. For that Supreme Lord, as a dedication to that Lord, when we do the yajna, it frees us from all karmic bondage. Mukta sangha samachara. So yajna helps us to achieve prosperity individually and as a society. Yajna purifies the environment. Yajna helps us to dedicate ourselves to a higher purpose, to the altar of the Lord, and destroy our karmic bondage. And yajna also helps us to be in tune with the entire universe. In our culture, we have the concept of Pancha Mahayajnas. Yajna also helps us to mitigate the losses that we are causing to the environment by our very existence. When we breathe, when we eat, when we walk, when we clean, when we use fire, even when sometimes our professional work that we do, or while cooking, while grinding, while farming, many such actions when we do, there are many microorganisms and jivas which get killed. So how do we ensure that the losses that we are causing today by our existence, we are able to replenish the resources of nature? Today, when everybody is speaking about ecology and carbon footprints and replenishing natural resources, recycling, reusing, it is important for us to know that our culture had taken this into consideration much earlier, and the Vedic culture tells us to do Pancha Mahayajnas, 5 yajnas, so that we replenish the nature. Deva yajna is by doing the havan, by offering the ahutis, nurture the phenomenal forces. Rishi yajna, study, understand, and share the Vedic knowledge so that more and more people and the succeeding generation learns to live this deep culture which lives with the vision of oneness. Pitru Yajna, pass on the traditions of the family to the next generation, perform the karmas like Shraddha, etc. Manushya Yajna, take care of the guests, the family, the relatives, do charity for those who are needy, help the poor, teach the illiterate, take care of the human beings around. And Bhuta Yajna, take care of all the other beings also, by taking care of the cow, the crow, the dog, by putting the kolam many times, the small creatures like ants, etc. get fed properly. We take out separate morsels of food for many of these creatures, water the tulsi, we worship the Gangaji, all the great rivers, trees, many things in nature, we revere, we worship, we honor them. All this helps us to be in tune with the entire totality and ensure that by our existence, what we are consuming, we definitely replenish back. So this is the beautiful understanding of the yajna. And Lord Shiva is of the nature of this holistic understanding, and hence his name is Yajnamayaha. Also, when we speak about yajna, just like we saw that yajna is not limited to a fire ritual. The Panchamahayajnas include so many other aspects. The fire is lit outside for the ritual to be done in Deva Yajna. In Rishi Yajna, when we study the fire of knowledge rises in our heart, destroys our ignorance. Pitru Yajna, the fire of faith arises that there are Pitrus who exist even after they have dropped the body, and their blessings we invoke through Shraddha Karma, by doing our duties, by living the traditions and culture they taught us. So the light, the fire of faith is lit. The ahuti of skepticism, etc. is offered. When we take care of the atithi, the jataragni in them, by feeding them, taking care of them, that fire is being fed. And the same Vaishvanar Agni is in the other beings also. So by taking care of those beings, we are offering the ahutis of food, water, etc. for them, taking care of them. So in all these five, there is a symbolic fire and into which there is an offering which has been made. Like that in the Gita, there are more than 12 types of yajnas which are given. Dravya Yajna is one where we offer charity by giving food, clothes, books, stationery, medicines, etc. Pranayam Yajna is there where we do the balancing of the pranas. Ahara Yajna is there where we eat proper sattvic food, balanced meals. Swadhyaya Yajna is there where we study. Atma Sanyama Yajna is there where we control the senses. So many different types of yajnas are mentioned in our scriptures. And it is said all these different types of yajnas are most auspicious. And hence, Lord Shiva is called as Yajnamayaha. In Vishnu Sahasranam Bhashya on this word Yajnaha, Shankaracharya has written, Sarva Yajna Swarupatvat Iti Yajnaha. One who is of the nature of all different types of yajnas and who brings auspiciousness to people, that is Yajna. Hence, let us live in the true Yajna spirit, learn to evolve, get anchored in the Yajna Bhavana. Individually, we can progress and evolve. And as a society, as a country also, great things can be achieved when we learn to work together for the sake of the country, putting aside our differences and doing our best. May the Lord, who is Yajna Swarup, bless us all with more and more peace, prosperity, and abundance.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.